that
sorry to interrupt you. Can you be a little bit louder?
About div tag attributes, JavaScript expressions, ternary expressions, about styling.
Okay. Yeah, so what we discussed was, so do you want me to go through it or start some new thing?
Yeah, start, you can start with the new thing.
Okay. So we'll do CSS, how to apply the CSS for React elements.
Okay. What about props?
No, we'll first go, we'll first study the CSS and then enter into this states. Okay?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, no problem.
Okay, so from basic we are doing, okay? So we'll do everything.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So now you have made some HTML pages, right?
Yes.
Okay, so in that you might have applied the CSS, right?
Yes.
Okay. So you might be familiar with what is ID and what is class, right?
Yes, I'm familiar with that.
Okay. So so similarly here we use ID and classes to apply the CSS. Okay. So what is CSS? Is like just HTML tags, right?
Yes.
We are using only HTML tags. So the attributes will also remain the same, right?
Yes.
Okay, so it is similar, just the syntax is little bit different. So for class we write class name.
Okay,
so like this few syntaxes are different. Okay, otherwise most of the things are same only. So in last lecture what I explained to you, there are three types of stylings. First is inline styling, external styling and internal styling. So inline styling you will give for the element inline only, right?
Yeah, within the HTML.
Yeah, style tag equal to code semicolon and then whatever the style you need to give, you will give, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Now there will be inline style, internal styling. Internal styling will be between the style tags in the HTML. You might have come across that internal styling also somewhere, right?
Yeah. The HTML. We have discussed in last class also.
Yeah, in the HTML page itself we give the style tag, okay, not to the element but inside the head tag of the HTML or inside the body.
Okay
within the style tag. Okay, and now we are going to external styling. So what is the external styling? We'll write the CSS in some other external file and then we'll use it, then we'll import it, okay, and then we can use it.
Okay,
so these are the three types of three ways in which we can apply the CSS. Okay, in HTML. So now as we go into JSX, okay, so we'll see the different ways how we can apply the CSS. So what do you understand by this? Whatever I'm highlighting, just tell. What is this?
This is header component.
No, yeah, this is a component, okay, which is extending this React component. Why they are writing as React.component? Can you explain me?
Just for extending the component.
No, but we have written it here as component, right? But yes. Here you see here it is React.component.
Okay, no, I don't know the difference about that.
Okay, so here we have imported component also from the React package.
Okay.
That's why we can directly use the component. But if you see in this code, they haven't imported, they have imported only React.
Okay,
that's why we are writing React.component here. If they have imported component also, then we will use this component. Okay, only component, not React.
Okay,
so you got this?
Yeah, I got this.
Okay, then the render method is of this React.component only. Okay, then what we return is this HTML tag. okay?
Yes.
HTML. Okay, now we are applying CSS to this HTML. So this is the style tag, and this is how we apply the CSS.
Yeah, in curly braces.
Okay, but why two curly braces? Why?
I think only one curly brace is needed, right?
No, one curly brace is for JavaScript. But now why we are using two curly braces?
Yeah, for styling.
No, this is an object.
Okay.
Okay, so we are passing object. Okay, you are familiar with the object?
Yeah, I'm familiar with that.
Okay, what is the object like this? Okay, so that day I told you, right? Style. So this is the object, right? We have written like this only, right? Style.
Yes. Okay.
So this is the way we solve how we apply the inline CSS, right? So this is the object. Okay.
Okay.
So this is the object.
Okay. Right? Yeah. Okay,
so that's why we are. So that's why we are giving two curly braces. This is for the JavaScript. Okay. Sweet. And we are telling that this is an object. That's why. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
So this is the inline method of applying the CSS.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now. So if you go through the in JSX, JavaScript expressions are written inside the curly braces. Okay.
Okay.
And since JavaScript objects also use curly braces, the styling is. The styling in the example above is written inside two sets of curly braces, right? So what they have told, since the JavaScript objects are also used curly braces, okay?
Okay.
So these are what I wrote is JavaScript object only, right?
Yes.
See, this I wrote JavaScript object only, and this JavaScript object uses the curly braces. That's why we are using two curly braces. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So this is the inline method.
Okay.
Now, okay. Now you have come across the CSS. Now suppose in normal CSS. Okay. Now you have to give the background color. So how you will give in the CSS background color to some div?
Yeah, just background. Yeah, some just I'll write just background colon some color.
But that background color will be like background hyphen color, right?
Yes.
Okay, if you see here. It is like this.
Yes.
But here we have written, but here we have written like this.
Okay.
So this is a syntax this we need to use in JSX while writing. Okay. So all the hyphen should be removed. Okay. And we should write this as camel casing. So this is called as camel casing. Like first word is small, and after the first word is over, then the next word is, the next letter is capital.
Okay.
Okay, this is called as camel casing. So this camel casing is used in Java, in JavaScript. Everywhere this camel casing will be used. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
Wherever the hyphen is there, you need to replace it by that camel cased thing. Okay.
Okay.
So instead of background hyphen color, we'll be writing as background color. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is light blue. Okay, and we are giving two curly braces because this is an object.
Okay.
Okay, so this is the way to write the inline styling. Okay.
Yeah.
Now again, you can write this inline styling like this also. Like you can assign a variable. You can assign a variable. This is an object, right?
Yes.
Okay. And this, now why here only one curly braces? Tell me.
Well, it is in JavaScript. It is converting into JavaScript, the object.
Yeah, but why there are not two curly braces here?
we return in render method above styling because it is
yeah,
eternal.
Because it is written here. Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
That's why. Okay.
Good. Okay, yeah.
So now, so suppose here we are using only one attribute of CSS. Okay, background color. But yeah, if there are many attributes, then how will you do? Then how? Then every time you have to put comma, right? Background color, right? Light blue, comma, width 10 pixels, comma, height 10. So this line,
yeah,
this line will increase, right? Line size will increase, right?
Yes.
So it's better you store it in a variable and then give okay that variable to that, right? So that okay only here. So this is only what they have done here.
Okay.
Okay. So yeah, this is a modularization. You can write all this here also, okay, within okay the curly braces. Okay, but it will be not that but it won't be that readable, right?
Yes.
So to bring that modularization, they have used this. Okay,
okay.
Now it is much better, right? It is much readable. Yes. Okay,
yeah, it is much better.
Now see, now now this app.css they have made, right?
Yes.
So this is a external file.
External, okay, yeah.
This they are not writing internal or they are not writing inline, right? This okay is an external file, okay?
Okay.
So what they have done is they have imported this. They have made this app.css a different file and just okay imported here.
Okay.
And yeah, what class, and it is applied to body, right?
Yes. So
if you see here, this body will be black in color.
Okay.
Because this is applied to body only, right? Body of the HTML.
Yeah, it have applied to body.
So if you see in our example, This all things are red, right? Red in color.
Yeah, red in color.
So what we have done is, in the app.js, we have used this button class, right? Class name equal to button.
Button.
And made this as an external CSS.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, dot button. Understood.
And this button we have given here. Fine?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, I'm fine.
Fine?
Yeah, fine.
Okay. Okay. So this is one type of external CSS.
Okay. Actually, in at present, I think we can use only external, right? In most of the cases, you will use external only, right?
It depends upon you. How much, okay, what is your, application size, okay, if okay you want to use internal, you can use internal. If you want to use inline, you can use inline, okay, but if you want to use external, you can use external. But in okay actual, when you do job, okay, and okay you come across code, okay, so suppose you are writing the code in JSP page,
okay,
you know JSP. You know JSP page?
Yeah, I know, but I forgot.
Yeah?
About that, yeah.
Okay, so in JSP page, you do, if you do any change, like you, if you put full stop also, okay? So okay to reflect that change on the server, okay? That means on the main production site, what is available for all the user, you need to do a build, entire build of your application.
Okay.
Okay, only then it will take that change. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, only then. But if you do that, but okay. So if I have one div in JSP page, and suppose you got a requirement to make that div background color as red. So
okay,
if you put that inline CSS inside the div, style equal to then color red. Okay.
Okay.
Then if you promote that code, promote means if you put that code on the server, okay?
Okay.
Okay, then you need to give server build entire time. Okay, so that server build is time consuming. It will take around 30 minutes, 1 hour. Okay, but if you have separate CSS file, so in so now what you have to do, just you need to change, you have a class for that div. Okay, already you have a class for that div. Just in CSS file, you have to write color equal to red. Okay, and promote that code. Okay, to the server. Okay, so CSS build, HTML build will only take like 5 minutes or 2 minutes. So that is better, or giving the build for 30 minutes is better?
Yeah, 2 minutes is better.
Okay, 5 minutes is better, right? So that's why we put this in extra separate file.
Okay.
So that handling will be easy. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Now this is an external type. Okay. Now this is something new. You will see CSS modules.
CSS modules.
You have heard about this?
Oh no, I didn't heard about this. What is this?
You have heard about this?
Oh no.
Okay. So this is a new concept in React.js, CSS modules.
Okay.
Okay. So I didn't heard. There are 10 components. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Ten. Suppose there are 10 components in your. Okay. Leave it 10. Only 2 components you have. Okay.
Okay.
Now what you do is what we previously what we discussed is external CSS, right? So you will write some external CSS button equal to red. Okay, in the CSS file.
Yeah.
Color red. Okay. Yes. And then you will import that in the main.css, main.jsx.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
So in main.jsx, main.jsx will load every time, right? When you execute, because as it is a main file, it will be loading every time, right?
Yes.
So whatever component will have button class, it will get the color red, right?
Okay. Yeah.
Suppose I have 2 components. There are 2 buttons. Okay.
In
one component, but only in one component I need that button to be red. But in another component I need that button to be blue.
Okay.
Okay. But what you have done is you have included that CSS in the main component. Okay. So main component is the parent component. Okay. So whatever it will load inside that and whatever component will have the button class, it will give red to that. Okay. So now if I have 2 components, both the component will get red color to that button.
Okay.
But what is my requirement? My requirement is one component in one component I need button in red color, and in another component I need button in blue color, right?
Okay.
But I have included that in main.jsx. So every time it will execute and all the buttons will get the red color, right?
Yes.
But by using CSS module, you can import CSS for that particular component itself.
Okay.
Okay. Suppose there is an app component and a home component. Okay. So no need to import that CSS in the main component. Okay.
Okay.
Just import that CSS in the home component itself.
Why like that?
Yeah.
Why we should do like that?
Because home component button, it should be blue in color, right?
Yeah. Okay.
And app component button should be red in color.
Okay.
But if you include in the main component itself, the home as main component has both home component as well as app component. Okay. So both the buttons will if both the button divs will have class button itself, right? Button class will be common for both the component, right?
Okay.
Suppose home component. Okay. I will just try to understand.
Yeah, can you give me one example?
Yeah, this is confusing. Okay. Yeah. Okay. This is the app component. This has classes button.
Yeah, yes.
Okay. Now this is click me component. This also has classes button. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. But
click me component color, okay, but click me comp as I have included this template, as I have included, okay, just a minute. As I have given this button as red color, okay? Okay. As I have given this button as red color, so and included in the this HTML.
Okay.
Okay, and included in this HTML page. Okay. So
okay.
This and HTML and whatever the component will be rendered within this div, right? I taught you last lecture, right? Whatever the components are there will be rendered within this div, right?
Yes.
So if I include this link tag inside the HTML page, it will be applicable for all the components.
Okay.
Okay. Be it as main component or let it be as app component. Wherever it will find the button class, it will put the red color.
Okay. Yeah. But if we keep in home component, it will will change to app component and click component. That's what you're saying, right?
Can you speak little loud?
In home component, we are giving the color is red and it will reflect the color to app component and click component, right?
Just a minute. In this CSS, I have given the color as red for button, right?
Yes.
And I have used this button in app component, okay, as well as I have used this button in the click me component, and I have included this CSS in index.html. Okay, so when this index page will load, at that time what it will do, it will see what are the button classes with button, okay, and classes with button it will give this red color, okay.
Why are we keeping that link component in index? We can't keep in main.jsx.
No, main you cannot include. You, if suppose leave this. If you design a HTML page, you where you include the external CSS in HTML tag, HTML page, right?
HTML only. Yeah.
So here also we are including this in HTML only.
But it is right? React, right?
Yeah.
But it is React, right?
It is React. It is React. Okay. But CSS concept remains the same, right?
Okay.
CSS concept will remain the same. You have to include that in HTML only.
Okay.
And if it is included in HTML, then this will be applied. Wherever the button class is equal to red. Wherever you have mentioned the button class in whichever component you have mentioned the button class is red.
Okay.
So if suppose in app component I want button class button color to be blue, and in I want button color to be red.
Okay.
So in this case, what I will do? I have included that CSS which have the button color as red only, right? And both the component has the button class same. So when the HTML page will load, this CSS will also load, and it will check for wherever the class name is button, and wherever the class name is button, it will apply red color, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Till now it's fine.
Yeah,
but
it's fine.
Red color only for click me component. I don't need red color for main I don't need red color for app component, right? So in this case we use the CSS module. What we will do is we'll import that CSS in that module itself. In app module itself, we'll import that CSS. It won't be imported in the main module. In the HTML page, it will be imported in that module itself. Okay. And what? Yeah. How we import is import style from, and this is the CSS name.
Okay.
So when you are using the module CSS module, you have to do CSS file name dot module dot CSS. This module keyword should be there. Okay, this is the naming convention.
Okay, module keyword is like suppose app component and another one is click component. That's what you're saying.
Yeah.
Module means click component, whether or it is app components, right?
No, you, this is just the syntax. Okay.
Syntax
you have to now you can write also mystyle.css.
Okay.
Okay, but this is the syntax you need. This is the convention. These are the rules you need to follow while coding.
Yeah, so if
any third person see, he knows that this CSS is for only this module.
Okay.
Okay. So now what we have done is import style from this style mystyle.module.css, right?
CSS. Yeah.
Okay. Now this mystyle.module.css has blue color class. Just an
image. Now we are using inline styling, right?
Yeah.
In app.js, we are using inline styling to change a particular color.
Just a minute. I will tell you. Now, if you see this CSS, my style module, this has big blue, right?
Yes.
Big blue. And what we are doing is style.bigblue.
Okay.
Style is this reference. Okay. This now, from now, if we want to refer this CSS, we'll be using style.
Okay.
Okay. So style dot, because we can't use this much big name every time, right?
We can't
use mystyle.module.css.bigblue, right?
Okay.
So instead of referring, this is the shorthand for this CSS.
Okay.
Okay, so wherever you need to refer this CSS class, you need to use style. Okay,
okay.
So when I do style dot big blue, so as big blue is blue, this blue in color, blue class will be applied.
Okay,
so now what I am trying to get you understand is, suppose there are two CSS, okay. One which is for that module itself, okay, and one for entire app. One for entire app. So for entire app, suppose there are five modules, okay. So five modules will have something in common, right?
Okay.
So that CSS I will keep in that.
Okay. In my style module, how can I change a color to red if I for click component?
Yeah.
For click component, I need another color. How can I write that?
You can change this. You can make one more class. Okay.
Okay. Dot red.
Make one more class and give that property. And here you can access that class using style dot class name.
Okay. Style dot another red.
Yeah.
Red color. But, right?
Yeah. But what is the concept behind this? Try to understand that.
Okay.
So that only I'm trying to making you understand. Okay. One CSS. See, app will have 10 components. Okay. Suppose you design 10 CSS file for 10 components. Okay.
Yes.
And 10 components will have 10 buttons. Okay.
Okay.
All the 10 buttons will be in red in color.
Okay.
So what you will do, you will make one common CSS. Instead of writing that CSS in 10 CSS files for 10 components, you will make one CSS, right? Which will have all the common CSS for all the components, right?
Yeah,
so that is the main CSS, and that CSS will load in your HTML.
Yes.
Okay. So suppose 10 components have 10 buttons, and 10 buttons will have 10 similar classes, button.
Yeah.
But for third component, I want that button class to have color as blue.
Okay.
So I will give, but my common class has that button class as red. Right.
Yes.
But I want there to be blue, right? So for that module itself, I will make a CSS.
Okay,
for that module itself. Module means a component.
Okay, in click component, I'll write import styles. line and I will change that color to blue, right?
Yeah, for blue. But
okay.
But how that component will take, but button class is there for button class is common for all in the common. So it should take red in color, but how it is taking blue in color? It is taking blue in color because we are
importing the stem module or CSS.
Yeah, because we are implicitly telling that styles dot blue in color. And what is style? This module.
Okay. Right?
So what it will take? Styles from this module itself.
Okay.
Okay. So blue color will be applied. Okay. Even though we have given red in red color to the comma red color in the common dot css.
Okay.
You understood?
Yeah, I understood.
Okay. So yeah. Styling for only that module. Okay.
Okay.
That component. Okay. The, at yeah. that time only you need to use that CSS modules.
Okay.
Okay. If you
yeah.
Okay. So suppose what you will do, you will copy this CSS and import it in some other component.
Okay.
Okay. Import it yeah. in some other component. But some other component will have style dot in but Black. Some other component will have some other thing. Okay, import yeah. style one from my style one dot module dot CSS. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
And in that you wrote style dot big blue. So it won't okay. understand what is styles. Okay.
Okay.
Because it knows style one only, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it will make specific to that component only.
Okay.
Okay. Because of this reference.
Okay.
See, now if I copy this.
Yeah, I'm a little bit confused. Could you please explain? You can explain here.
See, now if I copy paste this here style, okay. Now in this component, yeah. I will copy paste this style, okay. But here okay. I write as style one dot ABC is the class name, okay.
Okay.
Style one dot A B C. Okay.
Okay.
And here okay, so now okay. when I write style one dot abc, so it should take it from this CSS, right?
Yes.
Okay, even though I have included this, it okay. won't take from this CSS.
Okay.
It will
okay.
take from this only because okay. I have used the reference as style one.
Okay.
Okay, now yeah. I will copy this. And I will use this in login component. And in login component, I use style one, but it is style two.
Okay.
Okay. And here, suppose for button, I have written. Style one
dot
XYZ suppose. Okay.
Yes, style two dot right.
No, not two. I have written style one. Why two? I have written style one. So it will take
but from, you imported styles two, right?
Yeah, okay, I have okay. imported it. I have imported okay. it. No matter. I have let me import 10 styles. But okay. what reference I use is that is the main thing.
Okay.
Okay. If I use reference of this CSS, then it will take from this CSS module. If I use reference okay. for this CSS, it will take from this CSS. Okay. So this is something like okay. unique key. Okay. If I call, okay. If your name is Srilata.
But only one module dot CSS, right?
Yeah. If your name is okay. Srilata. Okay. So there okay. are 10 Srilata. If I call Srilata, all 10 Srilata will come, right? But if I call Srilata dot, what is your surname? Suppose, whatever ABC. So Srilata dot ABC. So only that particular Srilata will come, right?
Yes.
So that's why we are using this. Now you got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Even though Srilata belongs to component 1, Srilata belongs to component 2, Srilata belongs to component 3. But if I tell Srilata dot ABC in the component 1, then only Srilata for component 1 will be there, not 2 and 3. Okay. So that's why we are using it. So it will be, it is specific to that component only. It is not a generalized one.
Okay.
So button.css, so button class is present in the common CSS also. And button.class is present in my component CSS. CSS for only that component. Okay. But if I write button, then it will take from the generalized one. But if I write style.button, then it will take from CSS of that component.
Okay.
Because I have referred at style.button. That's why.
Okay.
You understood?
Yeah, I understood.
Any confusion?
No confusion.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now you explain me what is that?
If I have 10 components and 10 buttons, someone want only same color for 10 components and 10 buttons, so we should use suppose if the case is if they want 10 different colors, then we are using module.css, styles.module.css, right?
No, for that component only.
Yeah, for that component only.
Yeah, for
we
that.
Have one main.module.css.
Just remember this sentence. Just remember this sentence. If you want to give a component specific CSS, then you use module CSS. Okay, so that will be specific for that component, that module itself, or that component itself. We won't include that CSS in the HTML. Okay.
Okay.
So in the HTML, which we include CSS, that is generalized for every component, right?
Yeah.
Okay, but if we include the CSS in that particular component, then it is only for that component only.
Okay.
And how we refer that is using this reference variable. Okay. And reference variable, I have shown you how to make it.
Okay.
This is the reference variable we are making it.
Yeah, I've got it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Style. Okay, so you understood, right? For that component specific, then you need to use style, import style from that CSS file. Okay, and include that CSS file only in that component. So whatever you refer, like style.a, style.b, style.c, so that classes will be taken from only that component specific CSS. Okay, if you write class name A, then it will be taken from the generalized one. Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, right.
So this is like in JavaScript, you might have done a global scope and local scope.
Okay.
Hello.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Yeah, I'm not able to hear your voice. Please be a little loud.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Okay. So global, all the function will use the global variable. Okay. But if you declare a variable inside some function, that variable can be used inside within that function itself, right? It won't be used by all the function, right?
Yes.
So it is the same concept.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So these are the CSS modules.
Okay. I'll practice.
Okay, so on these four ways we can apply CSS.
Okay.
Okay, so one way is giving the inline styling. Okay, inline styling can be given like this also. Okay, or in the variable we can write this and pass the variable to style tag. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And in React, there is a rule in which we make the CSS thing as camel cased. So now it is background color. So it is background image. Then I also will also be in capital.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your voice is not audible.
Yeah, I'm listening.
No, it's not audible. Can you speak a bit loud?
No, it is hearing.
Yeah. So it's okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now. Yeah. Now this is the external method. Okay. In general, if I include this, it will be valid for all the components.
Yes.
Okay. This is the external method. Okay. And for particular module, then I need to write this. Like, okay.
Yeah.
Specific to that module if I want to give. Okay. So these are the four or five methods.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now for including CSS. Okay.
Okay.
See, now how we include is. Just a minute. Now for include, we include, suppose I included suppose I included CSS in some module. Okay. The module is app.module. I have included import style from this CSS module. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
But how Webpack will understand? What Webpack will do? Webpack will suppose this is the app module.
Okay.
And I have this module.css imported here. Okay. Now this app module is imported here. Okay.
Yes.
So what this means is entire this code will come over here, right?
Yes, in main.js.
Okay, entire this code will be here. Internally, it will work like this only, right?
Yeah.
Okay, internally it will work like this itself. Okay,
yeah.
So it has this also import.css. Okay, so how Webpack will understand what is this? Okay, so in Webpack we need to give loaders. So that loader will understand that this is a CSS file. Okay. And this CSS file is used for styling. Okay. So in Webpack, we need to do this configuration.
Okay.
So what Webpack will do? Webpack will test all the file with extension as .css and it will apply this loaders. Okay. CSS loader and style loader. What CSS loader will do? CSS loader will load that CSS and style loader will convert that CSS into link tag and place that path itself in the link tag.
Okay.
So browser understands only link tag, right? Browser doesn't understand imports and all. Hello?
Yeah. Yes.
Can you be a little louder?
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah. Browser understands only link tag. Browser doesn't understand import and all. Okay. But we are writing here as import. Right? We are writing and browser won't understand this. So we use the loader. So what loader will do? Loader will, instead of this import, loader will do like this. link.
Link.
Yeah, and source it will give as whatever whatever XYZ CSS, whatever the folder path is. Okay.
Okay.
So this will be understood by the browser, and in the link, and browser will import it and render that CSS on the page.
Okay.
Is that fine?
Yes.
So that's the use of loader, right? So why we use Babel loader? Browser doesn't understand these classes, right? Browser doesn't understand what is this class.
Yeah.
But what Babel loader will do, it will transpile this into a JavaScript code, like functions. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
And functions browser understands, right?
Yeah.
So browser will render that functionality. Okay.
Okay.
That's why we are using the loader. Okay.
Okay.
So in detail, tomorrow we'll do an example in detail for this.
Okay, sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
So till now you are clear with all this? See,
I'm clear. I will also drive an example for this today. Okay.
Yeah.
I will also drive an example for this.
I'm not clear at what you are saying.
I also can try one example today.
Yeah, you can also try one example today. You can visit this link, W3 School, okay, React CSS, okay. So you can try it, okay, tomorrow.
Yeah, sure.
But tomorrow we'll do that example. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Then we'll move to states and props, okay.
So,
now how we have proceeded, like, first introduction to React.js, then setup of the React.js, then HTML part, then CSS part, and then we'll do data transfer, AJAX call, everything. Okay.
So
you combine all that in the end, you will make an application out of it.
Okay, sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So just revise this by tomorrow. I will send you the video and
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Okay. Please send me the video.
Okay. This link you see in the video itself, and go through this link. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Srilata, any questions?
Yeah.
Okay. Any issues you are having? Oh, understand.